the historical origin of the captive mind is not parallel with colonialism. During the colonial period, there was no mental captivity in the beginning. The phenomena of mental captivity arose more or less in the 19th century, not in the centuries before that. Because before that, there was no intensive contact, intellectual contact with the colonial power, and there was no attempt to indoctrinate at this level by the colonial government. In the beginning, they were only interested in making money. When the British came to India in the around the later part of the 18th century, they were not colonizers in that sense. They were traders, but they started building forts. This building of forts was with the approval and support of the Mughal emperor. For instance, this was discussed in a very colorful and clear manner by a lady writer, Harriet Martineau, in her book, A British India, The History of British India, that during that period, there was no vision of the British as a colonial power. They were simple traders. They asked permission to build forts, to defend their interests against their own people, primarily against their own people, thefts and things like that, and against surrounding raiders. Now, they were not involved in introducing British schools, spreading the English language, having control of the country. They were not involved in all that. And the Dutch, after taking over control of Java in Indonesia in the 18th century, and when they started building forts in the 16th century, even conquering what at that time was called Batavia, Jakarta, it became their territory. They had their own government there. During that period, there was no captive mind because there was no interchange. It was only in the later part of the 19th century that there was this interchange, intellectual interchange, and schools were being started. And they deliberately set up an institution called the Balai Pustaka to translate European works into Indonesian. They translated a lot of European classics into Indonesian, including the works like Gogol, the Russian writer Gogol. There was a famous work of Gogol, The Overcoat, that was translated into Indonesian. Many other classics are translated into Indonesian, and they spread it in the Indonesian language. So the attempt to spread ideas in Indonesia started in the 19th century. So the colonial period, the 350 years of colonial period, only the later part of the 19th century we see this phenomena of intellectual exchange, intellectual captivity.